We need to do a much needed paycheck protection update. This is one of those updates that I really do not want to do, but I feel the obligation to present the good, the bad, the ugly with all of these programs that are going out and then try to be as factual as possible. I'll try to limit any amount of emotions or anything like that, even though I'm extremely frustrated with this situation. So let's talk about a document that was just sent to me that the SBA is sending to lenders, where we stand with the Paycheck Protection Program, and what's next as of right now. What exactly we can expect, what exactly we can do to help make things a little bit better here. So just for some context, the Paycheck Protection Program is out of funds. It's been out of funds for almost 2 weeks now. However, when they said that, it wasn't exactly out of funds yet. There was about $30 billion left, and there were certain loans that were already allocated for. They were basically just not accepting new applications in the SBA system, but they were also considering pretty much everyone who had already applied and been sent to the SBA. Under regular circumstances, you know, you just applied, you were sent to the SBA, or you applied a while back and there was some error code thrown on your application, or there was some issue on your application and there was some kind of hold code. There was about $6 billion in hold codes sitting there that was already allocated out of the $30 billion. There was about $8 billion left for CDI, CDFI lenders, for minority borrowers. So there was still funding left. It was just allocated in various areas. But it generally meant, hey, if you already applied, you most likely will still get funding. And I was very happy to at least see that, because I know most of my subscribers, most of the people who had been following this program, had already applied, and that just allowed me to rest easy knowing, like, okay, these people already applied, they will very likely get funding as all these issues start getting worked through. And now that there isn't new applications coming, it means the ones that have various error codes are going to be able to be solved. And most error codes here are solvable. There's just so many error codes at the SBA that they're starting to, you know, filter through these. And there's just literally millions of those sitting there. Most of the time, it's something simple, like a borrower applied through multiple lenders and the SBA system thinks that this is an issue, even though it isn't. That's a very frustrating issue in itself, because the SBA from the very beginning said that's fine, and then their system was like, that's actually not fine. Let's go ahead and throw a red flag for that. Other issues that are pretty common include things like, it might show that the borrower had some kind of bankruptcy that disqualifies them, even though they didn't. There's about 40 different error codes that can pop up, and it's very hard for lenders to determine what that error code is, how to resolve it, and what to do without the SBA saying exactly, like, send this document in and then we can send this, you know, along its way and get this person funded. So I was very hopeful that these would start getting worked through, but I received some news today that makes me pretty frustrated and pretty sad about this program, frankly. So here's the document that was sent to all Paycheck Protection lenders. There's about 5,000 or so different lenders facilitating the Paycheck Protection Program on behalf of the SBA. So it says here, dear lender, as a result of the Paycheck Protection funding exhaustion, the SBA is recommending the following actions by lenders as they conclude their PPP efforts. Lenders with not approved or further research status PPP loans are required to withdraw and notify their borrowers they will no longer be able to process these requests. So this is it's extremely frustrating. So not approved or further research. That means that anyone who was sitting in queue, whether you didn't have an issue whatsoever on your loan, or you were sitting and you had some kind of issue, lender secondary review, some kind of hold code at the SBA, the SBA is now saying those funds are allocated, you have to withdraw those loans and notify the borrowers, that's it. And this is extremely frustrating because, like I said, they were telling everyone that, hey, these are allocated for, there's $6 billion in funding allocated for these hold codes, issues like that. So I don't know exactly what's happening here at the SBA, but it's extremely frustrating that the people who were sitting there with hold codes, whether you applied 2 months ago, you got some kind of hold code, the SBA is now saying, hey, lenders, tell them that's it. You know, we're closing up shop. So the SBA will remove all loans remaining in not approved and further research status from the origination platform by 5 p.m. Eastern time on May 17th, 2021, which is Monday. So anything that's not approved by Monday, they're basically saying you're out of luck as of right now, unless something happens with Congress. So that basically means the last day that the SBA can approve something, send it to your lender, is Monday. Now, this means you could receive funding after that, because remember, there's about a 20-day period where after the SBA approves your application, your lender then has that time to fund you. So it's 20 days that they have to fund you, and then, you know, an ACH payment can take 3 to 5 days, so it really could be more like 25 days. So that doesn't mean if you don't receive a deposit on Monday that you're SOL, for lack of a better term, but it just means that's the last day that they can actually, that they're actually going to approve anyone before 5 p.m. Eastern time. It's just so frustrating. So it says this action will allow PPP borrowers to engage in alternative CFI lenders before the program expires on May 31st, 2021. So they're saying you're gonna be withdrawn if you're not approved by Monday. You'll still be able to apply through a CFI, CDFI if you're an eligible minority or person who fits within that criteria for that, you know, $8 billion in funding. Now, many lenders are rerouting those loans automatically, like Blue Acorn, Wamply. They are automatically, if you were, you know, applied through some lender and that wasn't a CDI, CDFI and you hit the criteria, you should be rerouted automatically to a lender that still has the funding left. But of course, that funding's not going to last very long with this huge shift of people over to those lending institutions. And you still can apply directly through a CDI, CDFI. I'll have a link down below so you can find, you know, a matchmaker tool for those if you choose to throw in another application just to try and, you know, throw something at the wall and hope that something sticks. But like I said, this is extremely frustrating that it's just like we're just being tossed around. We don't know exactly what's going to happen from a week-to-week basis. It's like, come on. So now the important question to ask is, okay, what are the odds of additional funding? As you know, I've been very optimistic that more funding will happen here, as there are thousands and thousands of businesses sitting in queue here waiting to get funding with this program. I've compared it to the stimulus check, where, you know, they wouldn't just say, sorry, we're out of money for stimulus checks, you're not gonna get one just because you were further in the queue. So it just would not make sense to not add more funding to this program for those who applied long ago and they're just waiting for the funding for legitimate businesses. So what's next? I've talked to a few lenders and the general consensus here is that there's about a 30% chance that Congress allocates more funding for the Paycheck Protection Program. Now, I know this is not good. This is not more than half. That's kind of what I've been, you know, sitting at thinking. Like, I think it's a more than a 50% probability. Now they're saying there's about a 30% probability. But the odds of that have increased dramatically very recently because the Restaurant Revitalization Fund has now run out of funding as well. That program has been extremely popular. They've been able to allocate funding very fast with that program, and it ran out extremely quickly. So what this means, we now have two programs that are very popular, that have applicants sitting waiting in queue, and that need more funding. So what that means to me is there's even more reason to get more funding for these programs. It wouldn't make sense to fund one or the other. It would only make sense to fund both, since they're both popular, they're both helping out small businesses. So I think that the fact that there's now two programs that are out of funding, that actually increases the odds that Congress does something here. Now, it doesn't mean that the fight's over, it doesn't mean that that's guaranteed, but it just increases the odds. Now, there's still things that we can do because we still kind of have to do this grassroots brute force method to get something passed. So make sure, if you are sitting in queue, if you want to help out small business owners, make sure you contact your local representatives. By any means necessary, you can mail in a letter. That's probably going to take too long. You can email them. You can use the texting service. You can text RESIST to 50409. It takes like 2 minutes, and they'll let you just literally text on your phone, and they'll draft a letter that gets sent to your local congresspeople and just say like, hey, we need more funds for this program because there's obviously an issue here. There's obviously a disparity between the need and the amount of funding allocated. There's just problems here. We've just been kind of like tossed to the wayside here. There's so many businesses in need that just need this funding. So I'm just gonna try to remain optimistic here. Look at the silver lining, that the fact that, you know, the Restaurant Revitalization Fund is also out of funding. So that increases the odds here of more funding. There's a recognized need for this funding. Certain metrics aren't looking good in the economy, like the unemployment rate actually went up in the last month. So even though the economy is kind of trending in the right direction, we're in a bit of a road bump right now. So I think there's a lot of factors that may help get more funding, but the fight is not over with yet. So I'm gonna focus on the positives here, but be aware of the negatives. And you know, I'm doing everything I can. That's why I'm posting this video, to try and get more people to contact their local representatives. And this isn't for me, because I'm not eligible for another PPP loan. This is for all those who are sitting, waiting for more funding, and just simply haven't received that funding. So I hope that this was helpful. I don't like bringing bad news, but I felt obligated. I would like to thank you for watching. Make sure you're subscribed for future updates here, because I will update you on anything major that happens. And I just hope that you have a profitable day.